Hey, welcome back to my new root tutorial. Since we have learned already in the last video all the important things that we need in order to plot something in histogram, make a fit, draw a legend and so on, we will now learn a little bit more how to beautify our canvases. So for that reason, again, like always, we make a copy of the last file that we have created and we call it tut9.c and we open it now again for editing. So, one of the first things which one could do, which I personally like and which from my point of view makes it more beautiful, is to make additional ticks on the X and Y axis up and on the right side. So this we can do with the function set tick X and set tick Y. And if we run it now, sorry, this should be of course not the histogram, this should be the canvas. So we can write here C1, C1, and another problem we have forgotten of course to rename the macro. And if you run it now, we see that we have additionally ticks on the x-axis and here on the right y-axis. Another thing which I like more is to shift the legend a little bit more to the inner part of the histogram. So we will not start at 0.6, so maybe we can start at 0.5, and we also don't go up till 0.9 in order not to overlap with the ticks. So let's suppose we go only up to 0.8, and in y-axis we also start maybe around 0.6 and go up till only 0.8. And when we now run it, we see it shifts much more to the center. Of course, then it overlaps with the histogram. So in order to solve this problem, we can just increase the size of the x-axis, so of the limits of the histogram basically. So maybe we, instead of going to 10, we go up to 15. And then of course we also have to make our fit up, not up to 10 but up to 15, and now we can see it already fits much better. Then what I also normally try to do in my own histograms is to remove the margin around the legend. So we can write leg set margin, set border size is the correct command, set border size 0, which means that the width shrinks to 0 and therefore we don't have any border around. From my point of view, this looks already much better. Then sometimes, depending of course on the situation, but I also like some fillings in the histogram. So maybe here above the axis definition we can write hist set fill color. And let's suppose we want to fill it with green, but we don't want to make it, as you will see how it looks like, very prominent. So with plus and minus you can change basically the intensity a little bit. So if I write K green minus 9, it already gets a little bit better to watch. Then depending on where you want to publish it, it's sometimes better to remove the title from the histogram. So we can just remove the word histogram. Now it's empty. And depending on the size that you have to shrink later in your publication the size of the canvas a little bit. So it's maybe better to increase the font size. And this we can do by just looking where the axis definition was here, and we can write again hist get x axis as the function, and then not set title but set title size, and then there are some relative numbers which you have to give. It's a little bit playing around. I can also not say exactly which is the correct number that you have to choose. It depends on your canvas size, but in this standard configuration I usually prefer 0.05 as a good value. And the same thing you have to do, of course, for the y-axis. Later I can show you also some possibilities to make it faster, but for the time being this seems to be the easiest way. Get x-axis, and we are not only changing now the title size but also the label size. And if nothing, set label size. If everything worked well, we can see now that here the labels and also the axis titles increased. Then what one could also do, of course, here maybe in case of the legend, we can now insert also the filling, or we can remove the line basically of the measured data and write F for filling, because now we have a fill color which also looks already much nicer. And then maybe what is a possibility, I'm not sure whether it looks good or not, is to increase the thickness of the line a little bit. So maybe we can increase it to 2 if it does not look ugly. Okay, I think maybe 2 is the standard size, so maybe we go up a little bit higher to 3, then it's a little bit more prominent. What one can also do, we can change, for example, set line color. We could change the color of the fit function, and we could also change the line style. Let's suppose style number 1 is the solid. Of course, green and blue doesn't look so much nice basically. If we change the line style to 2, we are getting here a dashed line. This can also look good in some circumstances. And 3, I think, should be a dotted line. Yes, it's not so much clear visible, but maybe what I usually like is a dashed line together with a red curve, and I think this looks neat and clean. So the next, what one can also do additionally, I mean, there are many things which you can do in order to beautify it more, but what I normally like to do is also including a grid. So the same which you did for the ticks, you can write set grid x and C1 set grid y. And this makes sometimes sense if you want to make things better readable. So now you can identify the parts in the histogram easier. So from my point of view, this is already a nice plot that you can use for publications, for thesis, and so on. Maybe I will go a little bit more into detail in one of the next videos, but of course there's also much more other content which has to be done. With this, I hope, or with this nice impression, I want to close this video now. Thank you very much for your attention, and the next one will come very soon. So stay tuned.